glad you're with us. Joe Tessitore.
Here we go, Bob Smart.
Well, they're scheduled to go to full 12 here tonight. Round one now underway. Zapp saw that punch coming. Judah was able to block it away. Good flush, straight left hand. There's the hook. Takes one, gives one. The right hand scores well. When a right-handed fighter faces a southpaw like we see here tonight, Kenny, that right jab is right up against his jab.
That's absolutely right. And you know what? That's a great point, because there lies maybe the greatest advantage for the southpaw, because now the orthodox fighter doesn't feel comfortable using his jab. It doesn't land. It doesn't have the clearance that it usually has. And therefore, he doesn't use it, and he hurts himself.
Able to get away from that headshot with the block. Halfway through this round, Bradley's putting forth a great combination there. A little something for his opponent after getting tagged. Off target with that hook. And now he brings the left hand upstairs. Unbelievable pace here tonight. Both guys have no plans of having this fight go far. A big shot comes home for him. He just went down. The infighter went out, and now he went down.
Hey, it's okay to go out, but go out the side door. He went out the front door, and as you said, maybe paying the ultimate price.
Judah is going to have to pull himself together here. Now, he beats the count, but still a lot of work to do.
Yeah, a lot of work, because he doesn't have the benefit of his legs. Can't move around there wobbly right now. So what he's got to do is grab on a little bit and walk. Walk to the rope. Kill some time. Make the referee come in between you and break you.
End of the round. And this is a little bit hard to take if you're sitting back at home watching this fight and saying, I just don't get it. I mean, if you want to win the fight, you have to throw punches.
Maybe he doesn't want to win the fight. See, you're taking for granted that...
What, he's scared? He's fearful?
Hey, everybody's scared. Anyone who's in that ring is scared. He's not controlling his fear. He's not taking it, and that's for people in all aspects of life, whatever they do. You have to take whatever it is that can intimidate you, and you got to put it on the side and say, okay, right now, I'm not going to let that get in the way. He's letting it get in the way.
Off to the side, a little swing and a miss going upstairs. Takes one to give one. Uppercut in return. Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Halfway through round number two.
Come on.
Judah's on the heels of that knockdown he suffered, and right now he's in the arms of his opponent. He's just looking to clinch.
Yeah, that's what he's doing. He's looking to clinch. He's looking to clutch. He's looking to hug the guy. You know, he's looking to make sure that he's still here when this bell rings.
Good step back counter punch there.
Beautiful.
It's all right. Keep moving. Keep moving.
He just missed that shot up top. Fine fundamentals, good counter punch. Just 10 seconds to go here in the second round. Now, that counter punch landed with some success. How about that left hand? Scores well to the belt line again. Lands the straight right. Missed that uppercut. Solid left hand to the head. keeps his hands up defensively, protecting the head. Bradley's way off the mark. That punch didn't have a chance. Coming to the halfway point of this third round. Good, clean shot, returning fire. Well done by Judah. Targeting the left hand to the body. He gets hit, but he gives it right back.
Circle, circle.
Bradley's left, working well that time. I like the way he went up top that time with the hook. A well-placed left hand up top. Bradley's the kind of boxer that wants to do just that. Find the target, get the combination working, land both punches. Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top.